Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to Bahria Collage Majid online lecture for class 7 science subject. I am Kanita Ahmed. Today we are going to learn about elements, the simplest kind of matter from chapter number 9. Learning objective for this chapter is at the end of this lecture you will be able to understand that all matter is made up of elements, identify an element as the simplest kind of matter, understand how elements are classified in periodic table according to their properties. Let's start with today's topic. Our topic is element, the simplest kind of matter. For that, we have to know what is matter. Anything that occupies space and has weight is called matter. Already you have learned in your previous classes, matter is anything that takes up space, everything on earth is matter. Matter exists in three states, either it can be solids, liquids or gases. So what is an element? An element is a substance which cannot be split into two or more simpler substances by chemical reaction. Actually, it is the simplest kind of matter. It is very small unit that cannot be break into two or more substances. There are 118 elements known today by chemical changes and 91 in nature and rest by made by humans. Well, single element cannot do anything. All element combined to form our body, the world. The entire whole universe depend upon the elements. Let's talk about the abundant element in the universe. The most abundant element in the universe is hydrogen, that is 93.5%, and then helium, that is 6.3%, then oxygen, carbon, neon, nitrogen, magnesium, silicon, iron and so on. But when we talk about earth, in earth crust there is the most abundant element is oxygen, that is 46.6%, then silicon, then all other elements. It is easy for us to learn all the elements and their percentages? No, it is not so easy for learn us all the elements and their percentages. So how elements can be classified? Classifying element by a table, a chart, which is called the periodic table, which is given by a scientist named Mendeleev, have classified elements into a chart called periodic table. This periodic table have a speciality that elements have been placed systematically in the periodic table according to their properties. Actually, it is placed in an increasing order of their atomic numbers. Well, each element in the periodic table is represented by a symbol and an atomic number. Periodic table organizes the element in a particular way. A great deal of information about an element can be gathered from its position in the periodic table. So it is very beneficial for us. For example, you can predict with reasonably good accuracy the physical and chemical property of the element. You can also predict how an element will react chemically with other elements. How elements are arranged in periodic table? Before going to that, we have to know that atomic number. What is atomic number? Every element has its number, that is called atomic number. Well, atomic number is actually the number of proton present in the nucleus. Every element in a periodic table given a number, that number is their speciality, and each element has a different atomic number. You see there are two elements shown here, oxygen and sodium. Oxygen atomic number is 8 and sodium atomic number is 11. Then there is a symbol shown here in alphabetically order, means that the first number is alphabet is O for oxygen and then sodium Na(y). We'll talk about later. And then this is the element oxygen and sodium. Now move to atomic symbols. The shortened way of representing element is actually atomic symbol, usually one or two letters, usually taken from the name of the elements. This is a list of common elements and their symbols. For nitrogen, N. For sodium, Na. Why? Because sodium is derived from their Latin Latin words natrium. So that's why they are they are given by a symbol Na. Then chlorine, Cl, carbon, C, cobalt, Co, then so on. So we can easily learn their symbols. This is the table, systematic way of representing elements. This is the table. In this, all elements are arranged in their increasing order of their atomic numbers. This is the scientist named Mendeleev. This is the scientist named Mendeleev. Well, this is the complete periodic table in which there are 118 elements shown. You see, there are some vertical lines and then some horizontal line also there. What are the vertical lines? What are the horizontal lines shows us? Elements are arranged vertically into groups. Well, groups, all the groups have similar properties, okay? Then horizontally into periods. But, well, in this they all are having different properties. Why? You see, if you look at one of the atom of every element in a group, you would see that that all the elements have a similar property. That's why they place in a group. Then if you look closely to the period, that is show horizontally from left to right of the periodic table, you will see these are distinct properties. You will see a gradual change in properties from metallic to non-metallic. Well, about metallic and non-metallic we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, for this, come to review questions. You can easily answer them. What is an element? Name five things which are made up of element. How are elements classified in periodic table? What is group and period in periodic table? You can easily fill these blank, I hope so. The most abundant element in the universe are? Yes, hydrogen and helium. Classify element into chart, periodic table classified element into a chart. Each vertical column in a periodic table is called group. And each horizontal row is called period. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.